A very good evening to one and all. Welcome to Swadhyaya session. Swadhyaya is an academic series. We intend to support the academic series and academic sessions for all those UGs and PGs who are in need of the academic support. We intend to plan the classes as per the syllabus for both UGs as well as PGs, especially when they are not getting regular classes as well as library supports due to this pandemic. So we have a panel of expert faculties dealing with each subjects with one class per week, each of 1.5 hours. The specialties are that you will avail notes as per the syllabus itself. The printed notes will be available to you and it will also have the previous set question papers or important question papers as such, along with key answers, and also research paper or research article links along with those notes. This will be very useful for you for further reference as well as for the preparation of your exams also. And all the classes will be available to you with recordings and PPTs. So you can prepare well for your exams. And via WhatsApp and Telegram groups, we will be fully accompanying you and supporting you for any doubts and clarifications regarding the syllabus points. So to know further details, you can always contact Dr. Jasool. He's a coordinator of Ayurveda Map. And I'll just sum up the schedules of the classes of Swadhyaya academic sessions. We have Prasuti and Sriroga on Sundays, Panchakarma on Mondays, Kaijigilsa on Tuesdays, Shalya, research methodology on Wednesdays, Shalya on Thursday, Prasam Bhaishijam on Friday, and Chalakya on Saturdays. So these are our ongoing classes and the schedules. So if interested, you can contact Dr. Jasool for further queries. And today we have the session on Kaijigilsa. It is taken by Dr. Christie. We welcome you, ma'am. We can start the session.
Thank you, Dr. Gauri. So, good evening, everyone. Myself, Dr. Christie Baby from Kerala, and I will be guiding you on your Kaijigilsa syllabus. So, this is my first class with you, and so I will be taking the first PG syllabus, first point of PG syllabus, that is understanding Vriddhi and Shaya of Dosha, Dhadu, and Mala. Tamshamsha Kalpana. This is equally important for PGs as well as UGs. UGs, the Chigilsa Siddhanta is being asked. Okay, so in this section or in this slides, I will be discussing what are Dosha Dhatu Mala, then how the Vriddhi and Shaya is happening, that is the Nidana, then the Lakshana, and finally the Chigilsa. So shall we begin the class? Coming to the introduction, as you all know, Dosha, Dhadu, Mala, Moolam hi Sharira. Dosha, Dhadu and Mala are the fundamental elements of our body. That is, they are the expressions of our physiological functions as well as the pathological conditions. According to Vagbhat Acharya in Sarvaroga Nidana Adhyaya, he has explained the Sarvaroga Karana. That is, Sarvesham eva roganam kupita mala tat prakopasyatu proktam vivida ahita sevana. This you have already studied in your BMS level, and why I highlighted Vibhida Ahita Sevana means that is going to explain the Vriddhi and Shaya. That is, in the commentary it is said that Ahidam Trivido, that is the doshas are having three stages of Ahita based on the Pramana, Guna and Karma. Pramana you can take it as quantity, Guna as quality, Karma as function. Based on these stages, there is Hina Yoga, Mithya Yoga, and Adi Yoga. Or it is the, in scientific term, you can explain it as Kala Artha Karmana. And because of these three stages, the doshas manifest in three ways. Prakrita as well as Vikritavastha. That is, Vikritavastha is again divided into Vriddhi and Shaya. In nutshell, you can say that there is Prakritavastha of dosha, Vriddhi as well as Shaya. And Vriddhi is again of two, Shaya and Prakopa. Vriddhi is nothing but the augmentation of the doshas in its sthana itself. But Chaya and Pragopa. Pragopa means it is the accelerated form of dosha. It is more severe than Vriddhi. For Prakopa to happen, there is no need of dosha dhatu involvement. Like I will tell you in detail, when the Vada Prakopa happens, Acharya has said Grishma Rudu, Ahoratri, there is no involvement of specific Ahara and Vihara there for Prakopa to happen. But for Vriddhi to happen, there is a specific Nidana must be there. Okay. Again, Acharya has also, Charakacharya has said that Sarvada Sarva Bhavanam Samanyam Vriddhikaran. Rasahedu Visheshesha. That is, the similar factors will lead to the increase of the same dosha, whereas the opposite qualities will lead to the shaya. Now, this is the basic, you have already studied in your first year. What are doshas? Vishvaikritiya, that which is susceptible to Visheshan, are called doshas. In this slide, this is the basic you have already studied. We will discuss guna and karma. What is Vada Dosha? Vagati Gandhanyoho. All the mobility actions is related to the Vata Dosha. That is mobility, pulsation, ingestion, deglutition, locomotor movements, sensory movements, respiratory movements, all sorts of movements, whatever happening in our body is under the control of normal Vata Dosha. And where is its sthana? Pakvashya. Pakvashya Kadi Sakti, etc. is that, but mainly Pakvashya. And regarding the properties, Tatra Rukshu, Lekushida, Khara, Sushma, Shala, Vishyata is also explained. No need to go into detail because these are just the basic. I am just brushing up because only for the presentation purpose I have included it in this slide. And the karma include Ulsaha, Uchvasa, Nishvasa, that is the respiratory movements, Cheshta, Vega. That Cheshta include locomotory movement, Vega Pravartana, you can take it as digestive, from the deglutition to the excretory movements, Samyak Dhadu, Akshana Padava. Akshana means all the sensory organs. Now, what is Pitta? Pitta is Tab Santape, that which is burning by the heat of Agni Guna. You know, Pitta and Agni are related. Agni Reva Sharire Pitta Andargataha. It is because of the Tishna Ushna Guna, Pitta is having the similar properties of Agni. But what's the difference? Pitta is Tishna as well as Drava. That is, Pitta is having a liquid state. And so if Pitta is more, if Pitta Prakopa is more, it can destroy, it can lead to Mandakini. That is, it will decrease the Pajaka property and finally leads to Mandakini. Just like hot water extinguishes fire, the same thing happens if the Tishna Guna is more. Okay, the functions include Bhakti, Ushmam, Darshanam, Shutrit, all the digestive properties. Then Prapha, Pitta is responsible for the normal lusture of an individual. And Sneha Guna. Why Pitta is having a Sneha Guna? Because as you can see, all the other properties, Tishna, Ushna, Visra, in order to balance that, Sneha Guna is needed. And the normal Sneha Guna of Pitta is the Sneho Mardavam Janeti. It gives an optimum unctuousness to the cells. Okay. Then coming to the Kapha. Kapha Dosha is Slish Aluminium. Binding, sticking, or adhering property is related to the Kapha. And the Kapha is having Gadi, like water. Ke Phalanidhi Kapha, Kam Nama Jala. That is, Kapha is derived from Ambu. Now, from here begins our session. Let's see the Samanya Nidana of Dosha. Okay, as explained by Charaka Acharya, no need to by heart the sloka in this area. Just understand the concept. Acharya has explained Ahara and Vihara. They are the general Samnidana. Okay, like Gramya Aharam, Amla Lavana Kadushara properties, Trivya, Virudha, Satme, Vishama, Adhyashtana, etc. Vihara include Divasopnam, Vyavayam, Vyayamam, Manasika factors like Paya, Krodha, Shoka, Lova, etc. And why this is important? Not here, but when we are discussing the dhatus, because this is also known as Dhadur Viguna Nidana. Because of conception of these Samanya Nidana, certain changes happens to the dhatus. And because of that changes, that results to the Roga. What are the changes that is happening? I will discuss when we discuss the Dhadu portion. For the Dosha part, just understand this much. Okay? Now, this is the Vishesha Nidana for Doshas. It is otherwise known as Prakopa Karana. As explained in Vakpada Acharya, Vakpada, in Ashtangada Nidanam, Sarva Roga Adhikara, the Vada Prakopa Karana is തിക്തോഷ്ണ കഷായ രൂക്ഷാൽപഭോജനെ ധാരണോതീർണ നിശാജാഗര അത്യുച്ച പാർഷണെ ക്രിയാദിയോഗ ഭീഷോക ചിന്ത വ്യായാമ മൈഥുന. ഐ ഹാവ് ക്ലബ്ഡ് ദ ലക്ഷണാസ് ആൻഡ് ദ പ്രകോപ കാരണാസ് ഓഫ് ഓൾ ദ ആചാര്യസ് ഇൻ ടു ദിസ് സ്ലൈഡ്. ഇൻ ദ നോട്ട്സ് യു ക്യാൻ ഹാവ് എ ഡീറ്റെയിൽഡ് ഡിസ്ക്രിപ്ഷൻ, യു ക്യാൻ സീ ഇറ്റ് ലേറ്റർ. The coming to the pitta, pragopa karanas, kadu amla levana, the guna is tishna ushna, vidatta or vidaha ahara, then the viharas include ayas upavasa maithunam, again the manasika factors like krodha, shoka, phaya, etc. Coming to the kapha, madura amla levana intake, snigdha guru ushna prayoga, afishyanti aharam, divasopnam, asyasopnam, brimhana, shartana, ayoga, alasya. Okay, this if you can by heart the sloka, it's good, but no problem, you can present it in a tabulated form. Now this is the vikrita vada lakshana. I told you vikrita dosha can happen in vriddhi and shaya. Again, vriddhi is of chaya as well as kopa. So vikrita vada lakshana, I have classified the all the lakshanas into one slide, the vriddhi lakshana, shaya lakshana, as well as prakopa lakshana. In the notes you can have a detailed explanation, and PGs please be attentive here. If you are getting a question of explain the dosha, vada dosha, vikriti, that is vriddhi and shaya with chikilsa, it is better you write when the lakshana give Sanskrit explanation for each term itself. It is more impressive. Okay. Karshyam, leanness, where the ruksha guna is more. Karshyam, discoloration. Why karshnya occurs? Because the sthana of vada is in tvak also. And ushnakami. Why ushnakami? Because the shida guna is more. Kambam, as we can see in vepadu or Parkinsonism, kamba is the feature. Why kamba? Because vada is having a chala guna. Their chala guna is more in that. That is why kamba happens. Anaha and shagrakraha, why pakvasha is the sthana. And so that lakshana has happened. Velanidrindya pramsham, and phrama is explained. Phramadhinada. Phrama means chakrarudasi. The person feels as if he is like moving like a wheel. Again, that is due to the vikriti of chala guna. In this manner, if you explain the lakshanas with the help of gunas, which guna is responsible for this lakshana? That is the amshamsha kalpana in explaining the lakshana. Okay, try as much to possible to put the gunas in explaining the lakshanas. Okay, coming to the shaya lakshana, why angasada happens? Angasada means kriyasu asamartya. All the kriyas are related to the normal vada functioning. So when vada shaya happens, automatically there will be less kriya. And you can see sleshma vriddhi uttamaya sambhava happens. When vada is decreasing, the properties of like guru, snikta, which will increase, that is the kapha lakshana will increase, like agni sadhanam, praseka, alasya, aruji, all those features will be seen in vada shaya lakshana. And coming to kopa lakshana, sramsam, vyasam, vyadam, swapam, a detailed explanation is given. Lots of different types of pain has been explained in kopa lakshana. Actually, kopa is much more, what you can say, an accelerated form of vritti. Okay. Sramsam means looseness, vyasam means dilatation, saushitya, porosity, etc. Now, coming to the vikrita pitta lakshana. In the vriddhi lakshana, you can see pitha avavasata, pitha tvak netrada. Why? Because pitta has got a function of raga. And when pitta vriddhi is more, that normal functioning of raga is altered. That will lead to yellowish discoloration. And why shudrit happens? Because of tishna agni. Then daha means burning sensation. Okay. Shida kamitva, because ushma, the guna of ushma is more, and naturally the person will develop a desire for the opposite quality. In shaya, mandagni is explained, shida kamitva, and prapahanya is told you. Prapaha is a functioning of normal pitta. When it gets reduced, prapahanihi is seen. And in if you observe the shaya lakshana, you can see the agni madhya condition, isn't it? Pitta and agni are having asraya relation, and so when pitta reduces, there is a features of agni madhya or ama lakshana are more. And coming to kopa, you can see more or less symptoms are same, but kopa is a more exudative or suppurative stage. Kodam, Sravam, Swedam, Kledam, all the features. Coming to the Vikrita Kapha Lakshana, in the Vriddhi you can see Agni Sadhanam, Prasega, Alasya, Gauravam, due to more Gurutva Guna, due to more Shida Guna. Or if you analyze the Vriddhi Lakshana based on the Guna, you can understand how each Lakshana is happening. And if you see the Kshaya Lakshana, you can see it is just the opposite. When Prasega and Alasya is there, there is Brahma Rukshada. And when there is Chaitya, there is Antardaha. When there is Adinitra, there is Prajagara. Sleshmashya Shunyatva. What are the Sleshmashya? Ura Kanda Shira Kloma Parvani. Tasa and Medha Dadu are the Sleshmashya. Okay. And coming to the Kopa Lakshana, again, it is more or less similar, except you can see Shofa in Prakopa, Kapha Prakopa. Now let's move on to the treatment principle or the Chikilsa Siddhanta of Dosha, Vriddhi and Kshaya. As I told before you, Sarvada Sarva Kavanam Samani Vriddhi Karanam. So the Samana Guna of Ahara and Vihara will lead to Dosha Vriddhi. And the Viparita Guna will lead to Dosha Kshaya. So what should be the Chikilsa? So Yoni Vartana Neva Pradhikaraha. That is, choose the opposite quality. When the Samana Guna is increasing, choose the drugs and treatment modalities which are having the Viparita Guna in the case of Dosha Vriddhi. That is explained as, for Shiyana Dosha use Brahmana Chikilsa, for Kopa Dosha use Shamana Chikilsa, for Vriddha condition use the Hrasa Chikilsa or the Kshaya Chikilsa and Sama Paripalaya. And in the case of Vada Vriddhi, Acharya has explained to use Snigdha Ushna Guru Madhura Amla Drevya, for Pitta Madhura Tikta Kashaya Shida Drevya, like one example is Yashti Madhu, for Kapha Vriddhi Kadu Tikta Kashaya and Shida Drevya, like Gugulu, for Vada Kshaya Ruksha, Lagu, Shita, Jatri, Jagarna. These are all, you can see, Vada provoking factors that has to be used as a chikilsa in the case of Vada Kshaya. Now, this is important for both UGs and PGs. You by heart the sloka. This is Ashtang Hridayam. Vada Siyupatramaha, Sneha Sveda Samshodhanam Mrudu, Swadamla Lavana Ushnani, Pujyani Aphyangamattanam, Veshtanam Trasanam Seko, Madhya Paushtika Gaudikam, Snikdoshna Vastayo, Vasti Niyama Sukha Shilita, Dibani Pajani Sita Snehasha Anega Yuvaneha, Vishesha Medya Vishitarasa Taila Animasana. Dosha Vriddhi Chikilsa of Vata is otherwise known as Vatasya Upakrama. This is the just the tabulated form of the previous loka for easy understanding only. The same thing is explained here. Shamana, you can use Sneha, Abhyanga, Sveta, Sukoshna, Kandusha, Dibana, Pajana. And for Shodhana, Mrudha Shodhana is advised. And everything must be Snikta or Sneha mixed. Sneha Vasti, Sneha Virejana, Sneha Dhuma, Sneha Nasya. Tasa must be Swadamla Lavana predominant. Ahara, Mamsarasa and milk. Amlapalam. Vihara include Veshtanam, Trasanam. Madhya prepared from Paishtika. Paishtika means corn flour, a type of corn flour. Sukoshna Parisheka, Samvahanam, Atapaseva, Brahmacharya. You remember, Vyavaya is a reason for Vada Kopa. So follow Brahmacharya. Coming to Pittasya Upakrama, the sloka is again important, but I haven't included the sloka here. In nutshell, the content of the sloka is this much. Tahara must be predominantly Shira, Krida, Madhura, Tikta, Kashaya. Vihara includes Sugandha, Shila, Hrithya, Gandha, Gandhana, Upasevanam, Kande, Maninam, Haranam, then Karpura, Chandana, Ushira, Lepa. These are all Pitta Shamana drugs. Listening to music, cool breeze, getting exposed to cool breeze, etc. And the Shodhana must be Madhura Shita predominant Dravya Virejana. Can you give an example? Aragvada. Coming to Shamana, Snehana and Abhyanga. Again, Kapha Prakopa Chikilsa, Kapha Upakrama. Sleshmana Vidina Yuktam Tikshna Vamanarejana. Here all Tikshna measures are explained, Rukshna measures are explained. Because you know, you can understand from the properties of Kapha. Guru, Shida, Saras, Nikta. So we must choose the properties which can reduce the Kapha Dosha. Like Anna must be Ruksha, Alpa, Tishnoshnam, Kadu Tikta Kashayagam, Dirka Kalasidam Matim, Redi Pridi, Prajagraha, Anegarubo, Vyayama, Chinda, Ruksham Vivartanam, Vishesha, Vamana, Yusha Hashaudra, Medokna Moshadam. Kapha and Medas are having an astral relation. That is why Medokna Moshadam. those drugs which are having the medhotna property can be given for kapha dosha also. Dhuma upavasa gandusha na sukhatvam sukhaja. This is again for a easy understanding I have tabulated. Same thing only, medhotna ushada, one example is kukulu. Okay. Coming to the dosha shaya chikilsa, substances that are you causing aggravation of the respective dosha must be used to overcome the deficiency. This is the explanation given for dosha shaya according to Susruta Acharya. That is, brahmana must be given for shina dosha. In previously for dosha vritti chikilsa, I have mentioned some properties of the drug that has been used. And here for vadakshaya, kadu tikta kashaya, rukshalita shita drugs must be used. One example is musta. For pittakshaya, amla lavana kadu, shata ushna tikshna. For kafashaya, snitta guru, madura, sandra, pichila drivya must be chosen. Now coming to the amshamsha kalpana understanding series, this is for you. Okay. That is, one method of understanding amshamsha kalpana is, I told you in the explaining the lakshanas. You can understand, you can analyze how each guna of the doshas is causing the specific lakshana. And the second method is understanding the dosha in various diseases. One example I have taken here is Atisara. According to your yukti and your confidence, choose at least two or three diseases where you are thorough in your Sandrapti and Chikilsa and apply the principle in that disease and then write your exam. Okay. In the Jwara, Atisara, Pandu, these are all Pitta Prakopa Vyadis. But what is the difference? In Jwara, the Tishna Guna of Pitta is more. That is resulting in Mandakini. That is why we are using Lankana Pajana, etc. In Adhisara, again, it is a Pitta predominant Vyakti. But what is happening there? In Vada, the Sammana Vada is involved here, where the Chalaguna is more, Shoshana Guna is reduced. That is why in the initial stage, we are not doing Stambana, but only Anulomana. That is why we are giving Haritaki at that stage. And in Abana Vayu, the Ruksha Guna is decreasing there. More Snigdhata is happening. And the Pitta involved is Pajaka Pitta, where there is more Dravada and Saraguna. That is why in the later stages, we are giving Grahi as well as Agni Deepana drugs, like Haritaki mixed with Pippali, etc. And the Kapha, Kledaka Kapha is involved, that is more Snigdhata and Shetaguna. In this manner, I have given only a clue of how to understand the Amshamsha Kalpana in various disorders. Okay, scholars, this is taking this as an example, whichever diseases you are confident in, write the Amshamsha Kalpana of the Vriddhi and Shaya of the Doshas. Got it? Now, understanding Amshamsha in Chikilsa. Till now, we were discussing the Chikilsas of Vapada Acharya, but Charaka Acharya has given a difference in opinion. That is, in Vada, Pitta and Kapha Dosha, treat according to their strength. That is, if Vata Dosha is having more strength in a disease, treat it first, followed by Pitta, then Kapha. Vrinda Madhava and Chakradatta in Sannipada Jwara explains that first do the Kapha Amahara Chikilsa, then Pittahara, and then Vadahara. But see, Susruta Acharya has got a difference of opinion. In Jwara and Adhisara, Susruta Acharya has explained to do the Pittahara Chikilsa first, followed by Kaphahara and Vadahara Chikilsa. Got it? This is the difference in opinion. Now that was all about doshas. Let's move on to dhadus. What are dhadus? Dharana dhadavaha. Sharira dharana dhadavaha. That which nourishes or maintains the tissues in our body is dhadu. And again, if you remember in the while explaining dosha, in the Samanya Nidana, I have explained Ahara and Vihara. I told you I will discuss in detail coming to the dhadus. That Nidana is otherwise known as Dhadur Viguna Nidana. Because of the specific Ahara and Vihara that I have explained previously, certain changes will happen to the dhadus. That is, in the note, I have given a detailed explanation regarding it. Now you just listen, okay? That is, what are the changes happening is that Mamsa gets Shidila, loosened. Vida hyade rekta, sandhi vimuchyade, looseness of the joints. Vishyandi and or analpa medha, the medhas will be less formed. Na sandhi asti majja, there will be no formation of sandhi asti and majja, and shukram na pravartate. Because of the ahara vihara, these changes happen in the dhadu level, which finally leads to ojokshaya, and its lakshanas like glani, tantra, nidra, finally leading to rog. Okay, just write the concept. Okay, no need to discuss, no need to explain the sloka, just write the concept of dhatu vigunam udana. And finally, how it is related to vriddhi and kshaya is that samana guna will lead to dhatu vriddhi and viparita guna lead to dhatu kshaya. And again, dhatu vriddhi and kshaya is depending upon three more factors, ahara vihara, that is just the above explanation, then pajaka pitta or jadaragni and dhatu agni. If normal dhatu agni is needed for the normal dhatus, if dhatu agni is more, what happens? Dhatu kshaya will happen. And if dhatu agni is less, what happens? Dhatu vriddhi will occur. So the dhatu vriddhi and kshaya is depending upon ahara vihara, jadaragni as well as dhatu agni. Now, coming to the rasa dhatu. The vriddhi lakshana is raso abhi sleshmavad. That is, all the features of kapha dosha will be seen. Why? Because the properties of rasa dhatu is shida, madura, snigdha, chala. Okay. And that is why the sleshmavad, they are similar to the kapha dosha only. That is why we can see the lakshanas of kapha dosha in vriddhi lakshana. The management is langana, like jwara in jwara and shundi in amavata. Okay. Then coming to the kshaya lakshana, raukshyam prama shosho glani shabda sahishnuta. And Susrada has explained hritpida, kamba shunyada trishna. Why hritpida occurs in rasa kshaya? What is the sthana of rasa dhatu? Hridaya. That is why hritpida occurs. And the management is mamsarasa, madhya and milk. Or you can choose kapha kshaya chikitsa also here. Coming to the rakta dhatu, as you can see in the lakshana, many skin diseases has been explained. Visarpam, pliha, vitrati, kushtam, vadastra, pittastra, gulmopa, kusha, kamala, venga, agni, nasha, sammoha, tvaknetra, rakta tvaknetra, mutrata. And the Susruta has explained rektanga and sira punata. Why Sirapunanta is explained? Because the mula of Rekta Dhatu is Yakrit, Pliha and Sira also. That is why Pliha Vidrati is happening. Okay, and Upadhatu of Rekta is Sira. That is why Sirapunanta is happening. And the management is when Rekta Vriddhi is happening, automatically we have to reduce the excess Rekta by Rekta Moshana or Virajana. Why Virajana is explained? Because Rekta and Pitta are Asraya-Asraya relation. Upavasa, Rekta, Pitta, Hari, Chikilsa. One example of is Guduji. Coming to Rekta Dhatu Kshaya Lakshana, Rekte Amla Shishida Priti, Sira Shaitili Rukshata. Sira is the Upadhatu, that is why Sira Purnada is seen in the Rekta Vritti and Sira Shaitili is seen in the Rekta Kshaya Lakshana. Okay. Now, coming to the Mamsa Dhatu. The Mula is Snayu and Tvak, and that is why Ganda or Udagrindi, Ganda or Udara Vritti, Kandadishu Adhimamsam, excess deposition will happen. So the management is Shodhanam in the form of Shastram, Sharam, Agnikarma. Coming to the Mamsa Dhatu Kshaya, there will be Anga Glani, Ganda Svik Shushkada, Sandhivedana. Okay. And Susruta Acharya has explained Dhamani Shaitilya. Why? Because the sthana of Mamsa Dhatu is Dhamani. Coming to the Medho Dhatu, in the Vriddhi Lakshana, Sramam Alpe Abhi Cheshtite Shwasam. That is, with less movements itself, the person will feel palpitation. Svik Sthanodara Lambanam. Excess adipose tissue will be getting deposited in Svik Sthana and Uddara. Snigdha Angada. Why Snigdha Angada? Because Medho Dhatu is Adi Snigdha, Adi Guru. And that is why the all the Angas will be more Snigdha. Daurgandhyam, because the mala of Medhas is Sveda. And again, Acharya has explained Prameha Purva Rupa Lakshana, Stauliam, Stauliopadravam are all seen in Medho Dhatu Vritti. And so the Chikilsa is Guru Abadarpana. You have to choose Guru Drevya, but it should not be Brahmana. That is Abadarpana. Like Yava, Godhuma, Gugulu, okay, Madhu. Vadakna Annapanani, Kapha Medoharani Chikilsa, Rushna Tishna, Ushna Tishna, Vasti, Ruksha Udvartana. You can see that the management is almost similar to the Tapasya Upakrama. इन मेधो धातु शय लक्षण स्वपन खटिया प्लीहनो वृत्ति एंड कृशांगद अर्थ लक्षण वै स्वपन खटिया बिकॉज द मूलस्थान इज खटी वृक्क एंड वपावहन ओके एंड द चिकित्सा इज ब्रह्मण चिकित्सा कमिंग टू द अस्थि धातु द उपधातु इज दंद ओके दैट इज वाई इन अस्थि धातु वृत्ति अति अस्थि अधिदंदांश अस्थि अद्य अस्थि अधिदंदांश इज अ फीचर अबनॉर्मल और ओवर ग्रोथ ऑफ अस्थि धातु इज हैपनिंग लाइक इन द केस ऑफ कैल्केनियल स्पर ऑस्टियोफाइट्स एटसेट्रा एंड द मैनेजमेंट इंक्लूड्स पंचकर्म बस्ति शीरसर्पि प्रोसेस्ड विद तिक्त द्रव्य And coming to the asti dhatu shaya, astanya asti todaha shadanam danda kesha nakadishu. Why there is danda nakapeda, danda kesha, nakaloma shadana? Because they are all the malaruba of asti. When the asti dhatu shaya, the malaruba also will shaya automatically. Coming to the majja dhatu, the upadhatu is kesha. And in the vritti lakshana, majja netranga gauravam. पर्वस स्थूल मूलानि कुर्यात् कृच्छ्राणि अरुंशीच वै नेत्र अंग गौरम इज हैपनिंग इज मज्जा एंड शुक्र इज हैविंग प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक दैट ऑफ कफ इट इज मोर गुरुत्व एंड मोर स्निग्ध दैट इज वै ऑल द नेत्र एंड अंग विल हैव मोर गुरुत्व एंड नेचर एंड द पर्पस ऑफ मज्जा इज अस्थि पूरण दैट इज वै देर विल बी डीप रूटेड अरुंशि इन द जॉइंट ओके पर्वस स्थूल मूलानि कुर्यात् कृच्छ्राणि अरुंशीच एंड द मैनेजमेंट इंक्लूड मधुर तिक्त अन्न व्यवायाम व्यायाम शुद्धि एट प्रॉपर काल इन प्रॉपर मात्र वन एग्जांपल इज आरोग्यद कमिंग टू द मज्जा धातु शय अस्तन मज्जनि सौशर्यम प्रम तिमिर दर्शन ओके देन दौर्बल्यम अल्पशुक्रद वै अल्पशुक्रद इज मेंशन्ड as you all know uttarottara dhatu vritti is happening majja dhatu is going to nourish the shukra dhatu when the sara bhaga or the sukshma majja dhatu is shaya what happens shukra dhatu won't get the portion and that is why alpa shukra dhatu will happen and parva phedam astitvodam is happening because sthana of majja dhatu moola of majja dhatu is asti and sandhi That is why joint pain and vata rogi. Pradatam vata rogi. In majja dhatu shaya, the patient will always say pradatam vata rogi. Okay, that is because asti and sandhi are the moola of majja dhatu. Coming to the shukra dhatu. Shukra dhatu vriddhi is adhistri kamadam, vriddham shukram, shukrashmirim api, shukradhyakyam. And the management is madhura tikta annam vyavayam vyayamam shuddhi that is shukra and majja dhatu are having the because of the similarity in the qualities both are having the similar management in the case of vritti and in shukra dhatu shaya you can see rogas like pandu shramam klaibyam shukra avisarga or chirat prasek chiratva either no expulsion or little expulsion or alpa rakta shukra darshanam Shukra will be mixed with blood. And the treatment must be Vrishya Chikitsa or Klaibya Chikitsa. Some drugs are Shatavari and Musali. Chandanam, Rakta Chandanam are also a choice. Now coming to the Chikitsa Siddhanta of Dhatu. You know, Dhatu Samya Kriya Tantrasya Asya Prayojanam. And coming to the definition of Chikitsa itself, you know, Yavihi Kriyavihi Jayante Sharira Dhatavaha Sama Sa Chikitsa. What all kriyas are that leads to the sharira sama of the sharira dhatu that is known as chikitsa as explained in the doshas also you have to choose brahmana chikitsa for shina and for vriddhi you have to use the opposite quality chikitsa and whatever shodhana and shamana you are doing it must be shaya avirudha that is it should not lead to shaya dosha shaya and in the notes I have in detail explained the dhatu gata Dhatu Chikitsa Siddhanta, Dhatu Vritti Karapava, that is not a must, but you just understand the concept. And then after writing this treatment principle, you can write the Dhatu Gada Vikara Chikitsa. That is already I have explained in the, while explaining the Lakshanas of Dhatus. Now let's now move on to Mala. Why it is called Mala? Because Malini Karnat Mala. Again, it is having just like Dosha, it is having a tendency to vitiate the others. That is why it is called Mala. And mala of anna is vit mutra rasa is kapha rakta is pitta mamsa is Mala Kishore Kamala, that is the malas from the Srotas. And the mala of Medho Dhatu is Sveta, that is why Daurgandhya Kandu happened in Medho Vritti Lakshana. Asti is Nakaroma, Maja is Snehamsha in Asti, Tut and Vit, Shukra is Ojas. That is, Shukra is not having any mala, but directly the Shukra Dhatu is changing into Ojas. And how we will understand Mala Vritti? It is understood by the Guruta and Sangha. And Malakshaya is understood by the Lakuta and elimination of excreta. Now let's see the Purisha Vriddhi Lakshana and Shaya Lakshana along with their management. Adoba and Kukshishula are explaining Purisha because Purisha is also having the same sthana of Vada, that is Pakvashya. That is why all the features are related to Pakvashya. And the management is Ama Adhisara Chigasa, that is Langhanam, Lagu Pojana in the form of Deepana, Pajana, Mrudushodana. Here Shundi is a good choice. Then Purisha Shaya Lakshana, there will be Andhrapeda, Sashabdasya Vayo, Kukshotirya Gurdumcha Pramana. That is, there will be a movement of Vayu in all the directions with sounds in the intestine. Hrit Parshapeda and Alpa Shakrit. Okay. And there the Chigasa is Soyoni Vardhana Chigasa. Drugs like gulmasha, masha, mushroom, goat's meat, yava, shaka, and danyamla are the options. This is only the explanation of the slogans. Coming to the mutra vriddhi lakshana, muhu muhu pravarti, vasti toda, and atmana. Vasti is the sthana, that is why all the features are related to there. And here, prameha chigitsa must be adopted, is explained. Coming to mutra shaya lakshana, Mutra Krichram, Mutra Vibarnim, Vipasa, Mukha Shosha, Vasti Nistoda, Vivarna, Mutra, and Rakta Mutra. These are all the different types of Mutra Krichra Dhavli, and that is why Mutra Krichra Chigilsa and the drugs explained in Mutra Krichra must have to be adopted here. Coming to the Sveda Vritti Lakshana, there is Tvak Dairugandhyam and Kandu, and I told you before, Sveda is the mala of Medhas, and so Medho Vritti Chigilsa must be used here. Sveda Shaya Lakshana Stabdha Roma Kupata Roma Chavana Tvak Paripatana Tvak Swapa Tvak Parushyam Sveda Nasham. Because Tvak is the sthana of Sveda. That is why all the features are seen in like roughness, brittleness is seen in the skin. Abhyanga and Svedana has to be used to promote the Sveda. Now coming to the That's all. Now we will discuss the previous questions that have been asked for PGs. This question has been asked for 10 marks, 15 marks, and 20 marks. So the questions, as you can see, describe Kapha Upakrama in detail with Vriddhi and Shaya of Tridosha. Okay, so the 5 marks, if it is for 10 marks, the 5 marks is for describing the Kapha Upakrama in detail, and the other 5 marks is for Vriddhi and Shaya of Trividha Dosha. Okay, so what all you have to include? You have to include the lakshanas of each dosha, but the chigilsa must be focusing to the kapha. Describing Vriddhi and Shaya of Dosha Dhatumala with chigilsa. This is a 20 mark question because you will have to write all the lakshanas from the nirukti to the chigilsa. You have to write in detail. And again, you can get a question like describe Vada, Vriddhi and Shaya with chigilsa. In that case, you can write only the what is Vata Dosha, its Nirukti, the Samani Nidana, Vishesha Nidana, Lakshana, in detail the Lakshana explanation, finally Chikilsa. And you describe Chikilsa of Pitta Dosha. Again, the same question, same pattern, write the Nirukti, Nidana, Samani Vishesha Nidana, the Lakshana, Vritti and Shaya Lakshana, and finally Chikilsa. And for UGs only, you can get maximum up to 10 marks, either 5 mark or 10 mark question. These were the questions. Explain Shukra Pradoshaja Vikaras with Chigilsa. And why I haven't mentioned Shukra Pradoshaja Vikara here? Because Klaibe is another topic in which have to be taken in detail. So that is why I excluded it from my presentation. And you describe Dhatu Pradoshaja Vikara with Chigilsa. Dhatu Pradoshaja Vikara means all the Rasadhatu, Tektadhatu, the what all lakshanas I have mentioned before. Mention one or two diseases and then how it is managed. Now, this is the key points of answering a question for the UGs. You have to write the Nirukti, Nidana, and the lakshana by heart the lakshana as well as the chikitsa. That's enough. But for PGs, focus on the question what is being asked. Suppose you will get a question like explain the vriddhi and kshaya of vata dosha with chikitsa along with amshamsha kalpana. In that case, you have to write all these patterns along with the amshamsha kalpana also that I have already explained previously. And taking that as an example, you have to prepare accordingly. And the one additional point for PGs is always end your answer with one or two formulations and medicines. Is it clear? Now thus we come to the end of the session. Thank you. Any queries, callers? Do you want me to explain again anywhere? Is there any doubts? Hello, I'm not audible.
Ma'am, there is a question in the chat box.
Let me see.
Please explain the Amshamsha Kalpana.
Yeah, that is the question where you can get PGs. PGs, the question I have already explained to you. Choose one or two diseases, okay, where you are thorough in the Samprapti and Chikitsa. Okay. One example I have taken is Adhisara. You can explain the Amshamsha Kalpana while explaining the Amshamsha Kalpana means which factor or the which guna in the dosha is responsible for this. Understood? That you can apply it either in the Lakshana part also. As I told you, where this is the Ruksha Lagu Shita Khara. These are all the gunas. Understand this gunas and then try to put it in the Lakshana. Coming to the lakshanas of each dosha, Karshya occurs due to which guna? Karshya occurs due to which guna? As far as possible, I have explained it in the notes. Okay, you can just read it and then from your yukti itself, you can come to the conclusion. One way of understanding Amshamsha Kalpana is in the lakshana part, this much. Then is in the chikitsa. That is, take one or two diseases and then apply the logic here. Okay, this Jara and Adhisara, I have taken only two examples because it is due to the time limitation. It is difficult to put more diseases, but this is what happening. In Adhisara, you know the Samprapti, which dosha is involved, Samana Vata is involved, and in Samana Vata, what is the gunas involved that is responsible for the Samprapti, and how we can do the Samprapti Ghataka, Samprapti Vikhatana. That is the logic or that is the main basic in understanding the Amshamsha Kalpana. Okay. Choose in Pandu also, you understand the Samprapti and then apply the same logic here. And again, this is the difference in difference according to various Acharyas. Charakacharya has explained to treat the doshas according to the strength. Vada first, followed by Pitta, then Kapha. But in Sannipada Jvara, Chakradatta has asked, told to treat the Kapha first, Pitta, then Vada. But Susruta again in Jvara says you treat the Pitta because Jvara is a Pitta Prakopa Vyadi. And so first you treat the Pitta Dosha, then Kapha Dosha and Vata Dosha. Understood? Only in one question paper only I saw the Amshamsha question. Okay, all the other are your direct questions only. You will get explained the Vriddhi and Kshaya with management. Okay, no need to worry much on it. Only once I saw that in the question paper. Okay. This is for PGs only. UGs, no need to worry on this. Your questions will be either very much directly. So by heart the lakshana as well as chikitsa. All the other things are just for your mark scoring or impression only. But the main factor is answer to the question. If the lakshanas are asked, you have to write the lakshana. It's Sanskrit explanation as well as modern explanation and chikitsa also. Vata, pitta, kapha, upakrama. If you have studied charaka, write the charaka sloka. And then present the explanation in the tabulated manner or point wise. Ma'am has raised cholesterol, triglycerides. How we'll understand with dosha? Usually these are medo. We can consider these as cholesterol, triglyceride as fat, and that is adipose tissues related to medo dhatu. Okay, so. Like one symptom in medo dhatu you can see is plihnovritti, isn't it? Wait, let me take the slide. Okay, we will discuss for you. I think there is another more topic coming, Chikitsa Siddhanta of Strothers. In that area, we will discuss the medovaha strothas related to obesity and prameha. That time you will get a more idea on how this adipose tissues and medas are related. Here I told you there is a feature called plihnovritti, isn't it? Why plihnovritti happens? Because it is a modern explanation. Spleen is the site for metabolizing adipose tissues, isn't it? So when medoshayam is happening, more and more adipose tissues will lodge upon it, resulting in splenomegaly. Okay. And the treatment is gugulu. You can use gugulu preparations, udruksha, udvartana. We'll discuss in detail when coming to medovaha strothas. Okay, no need to worry. Yes.
Any more queries?
Callers, yes, are you thorough with the slogans? Only if you are not thorough with the slogans, you have to follow the explanatory pattern. But the question marks, as you have seen, 20 marks is there. So it is very, very important you at least study the Chikitsa slogans. If you are having difficulty in studying the lakshana, you understand the difference, any difference is there between the acharyas. You can see from my presentation as well as in the notes also, I have included almost all the acharyas' opinion regarding the lakshanas. Okay. And understand if there is any difference or a different term is used. Write what would be the reason for that lakshana to happen. And then the chikitsa. Okay. If you are having difficulty in learning the lakshana sloka. But please do study the chikitsa sloka. It is very, very important. If you are confident or thorough with Vakveda sloka, it's better. Whatever. Come, you can ask me what all your queries. Do ask. And PG scholars, don't forget to mention the drugs as well as medicines. Like Ruksha Udvartana with Kola Gulatadi Churna. Okay.
Hello, ma'am. Hello.
Yes.
Ha, ma'am. Sorry. In case when there is no name of charak, susrut, or vak, but in papers and ask the gun, then whose gun we mention in the papers.
No, you are asking why I haven't mentioned Charaka Susruta specifically. No, this is only for the presentation point. I have clubbed all the lakshanas together. I hope you have obtained the notes by this time. You can see in detail what are the lakshanas mentioned by Charaka, what are the lakshanas mentioned by Susruta. I have given it in there. You can study it from there, okay? Only for the presentation purpose, I have clubbed it together. And what was the second question you asked? Hello?
Hi, ma'am. I am asking that. If it is asked in paper and there is no mention of any writer, then which writer we choose, or which writer is more good for in paper?
No. It is not depending upon the acharya. Whatever sloka you are confident, it present it beautifully. Okay. In Kerala, we usually follow Ashtangrudaya. That is why I put the sloka of Ashtangrudaya. That's why. If you are confident in Charaka, you write the Charaka Upakrama only. It is not, it will not be specific asked. Okay? You write the sloka in which you are confident and mention the extra points according to other acharyas. Okay? Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, fine. Is there any doubt on how to write the exam? This will be usually the first or second question. And then AMA is another important topic that has already been covered. In most of the question paper, you have, if you observe, this will be an area of usually the first or second question. But it's nothing to worry. It will be directly asked. Majority Vada and Pitta have been asked mostly. And in one paper only, Dadugada Vikara has been asked. In Dadugada Vikara is asked, you write the Rasa Dadu, Lakshana, Chikilsa, and then one or two, name of one or two diseases. Okay. This is for UG. And for PG, one explain in terms of one or two diseases and how in the Samprapti Rasa Dadu is involved. In Rakta Dadu, how in Samprapti the Rakta Dadu is involved. In Medho Dadu, how in Stavuli and Prameha the Medho Dadu is involved. Just if you study the disease itself, you will get it. No need to worry too much on it. It is simple only. Another question, how should PGs present their paper, ma'am? Can you put some light on that, ma'am? Yeah, I have discussed in the end. See, first you understand what the question is about. Okay, that should be your focusing area. If it is for 20 marks, the first question you see, describe. I'm taking that as an example. Okay, describe Kapha Upakrama in detail with Vriddhi and Shaya of Trivida Dosha. Now, for 20 marks, you will get a much more big question. That is the second question. Okay, describe Vriddhi and Shaya of Dosha, Dhatu, and Mala with the Chikita. I'm taking that question. Okay, and I'll tell you how to write. This is for PGs. UGs, no need to think much on it. You directly answer the question. What are the Vriddhi Shaya of each Dosha? Saptadadu and Trimala with the Chikasa. No need to explain more on it. It is a direct question. Okay. But for PGs, you start from the what is the factor for Vriddhi and Shaya that I have explained in the first slide. Vivida, Ahita, Sevana. Okay. Explain what is Ahita and how it is leading to Vriddhi and Shaya. That should be the first point. Sarvada, Sarvabhavana. Okay. The first point is that including these two points. The second point is the nirukti of dosha. You begin from dosha, nirukti of dosha. This is only, you have to write in one or two slides. Nirukti of dosha and what are the reasons for dosha, vriddhi and shaya. As you can put it in the table form itself as shown in my slide. Okay, no need to mention any slokas there. Just make the table and write the samanya nidana in the form of ahara and vihara. And then vishesha nidana. Okay, rasa guna like that. Then the shaya lakshana. Vada Vriddhi Lakshana, Vada Shaya Lakshana. You can directly write the sloga there, but it is for 20 marks. No, write the Lakshanas first, followed by Vada Dosha Chigilsa, Vada Se Upakrama. Then Pitta Dosha, same way, the Vriddhi and Shaya Lakshana Chigilsa. Kapha Dosha, Vriddhi and Shaya Lakshana Chigilsa. That's regarding then the Chigilsa management. The treatment principles is very, very important. You study, understand the principles and write it as point wise. Okay, I have given it in the notes. This is regarding the dosha. And coming to dhatu, write what are the dhatus, relation between dhatus and dosha. there, make a big table and just present it in the, no need to write the sloka there, present it in the table form that I have shown. Okay, Rasadhadu Dal Lakshana, Vruddhi Lakshana, Shaya Lakshana, and what is the simultaneous management there? And then Dhadu Chikilsa is very, very important. You can study my notes itself. Coming to the same with Mala also. Mala is not that much important like Dosha and Dhadu, but Dosha Dhadu portion must be very beautifully presented, thoroughly presented. And then same thing with Mala also. You can follow my table form. But here, what the sloga must be, Vada, Pitta and Kapha Upakrama sloga is a very, 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 very much important sloga. And in the treatment principles also, I have mentioned the sloga like Dosha, Shina, Brumhadavya, that you must study. This is the principle four of Chikilsa in Vruddhi and Shaya. Okay. And again, while describing the Vada Upakrama, in the end, you put two or three examples also. Drugs, like Abhyanga Vidhita, Nandran Thayilam, Sahajana Vidhita, like that. Okay. I will surely share my PPT with everyone. This is provided by the Ayurveda map itself. No need to worry on it. You can use my PPT. Then be free to ask any questions, okay? Because why was I fast? This already you have studied in your first year itself. I was just brushing up only. Were you able to follow me?
Any more queries?
Try to write the slogans as far as possible, as much as possible, okay? And do not write explanations in a paragraph wise, point wise. Ma'am, how to write the chikitsa of any disease in general? No, here the question won't be specifically asked to any rogas, okay? That you will get in the sources. Explain Pranavaha Srodho Dushti or Pranavaha Srodho Dushti Chikilsa with reference to Kasa or Shwasa. In that form only you will get. Vruddhi and Shaya, a disease will not be asked specifically. It will be Samanya Chikilsa. Write the Chikilsa of Pitta, write the Chikilsa of Vata. Like that only you will get the question. That is why Chikilsa part is equally important for UGs and EGs. That is why I told you to study the sloka. And again, while writing Chikilsa also, once you have written the sloka, no need to write in explanatory manner, paragraph manner. Analyze the Chikilsa Sutra and first you write the rasa. What rasa should be used? One or two examples if you know. Then second, what are the shamana procedures should be used in the form of practically how we can give. Then shodhana, what are the shodhana procedures explained with some medicines. Okay. Then finally, rasayana also. One or two rasayana drugs we can mention. Any more questions? Have you understood the topic? And have you understood how to write for your exam?
Thank you.
Hope the queries are over. Ma'am, we can wind up the session.
Okay.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, doctor. Thank you, Sandeep. Thank you, Priya. Thank you, Krupa.